Look, Morty, look! I turned myself into a website, Morty. I'm website Rick, baby. But don't play around with some of them anti-pickle serum I've stored somewhere safe. If I turn back to a human, I will have to go to family therapy. And we don't want that, Morty. This is the intro of Baby Website Rick, a web challenge from the OWASP Top 10 track on HackTheBox. Running the instance of the challenge, it is possible to browse to the website Rick homepage, where it is possible to read. Don't play around with this serum, Morty. And then the info, main.antipickleserum object at 0x7f88 blah 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 blah. As also suggested by the title of the page, this challenge focuses on an insecure deserialization vulnerability. Are you ready to find it and exploit it? Let's jump in. Let's first introduce what serialization and deserialization are and how they work. Serialization is the process of translating a data structure or object state into a format that can be stored on transmit and reconstructed later. Basically, it's a process for transmitting an object into something transmittable and storable, like a string of bytes. As opposite, the operation that creates a data structure from a series of bytes is called deserialization. So in this challenge, we need to send a serialized object so that when the server tries to deserialize the string and construct the object, it allows us to execute arbitrary code. Intercepting with barb suite the request sent to the server, it is possible to notice that the client sent a strange cookie called plain B. The code in the cookie, I can read some weird instruction like main or built-in object that suggests to me something related to Python, as also confirmed by the server fingerprint. At the moment, I can already assume that playing around with the cookie probably will lead to some kind of code execution or file inclusion. However, I don't know yet in what way. Because the word pickle appears multiple times, I start documenting about what it is, discovering that pickle is a Python module used to serialize and deserialize objects. As also said within the official documentation, pickle is not secure. It is possible to construct malicious pickle data which will execute arbitrary code during unpickling. Okay, so plan B is a cookie used to pass pickle serialization data to the server. From what I just read from the documentation, it is possible to send a malicious cookie in order to force the server to deserialize it and execute arbitrary code. But in which way? The documentation shows different methods that can be used to manage pickle data, as well as another module called pickletools that can be used to disassemble pickle objects. In order to better understand what is passed to the server, I wrote a small Python script that decompiles and optimizes the plain B cookie. The decompiled pickle is not very helpful, however, it allows to understand that the server is expecting an anti-pickle serum class object, as also suggested by the homepage. Okay. I have no idea on what to do next, so let's search online for any good article explaining this pickle vulnerability. One of the first results is this blog post from David's personal site, where it explains how to exploit a pickle deserialization vulnerability using the reduce function. The reduce method takes no argument and shall return either a string or a tuple. The semantics of each item are in order. A callable object that will be called to create the initial version of the object, a tuple of arguments for the callable object. An empty tuple must be given if the callable does not accept any argument. So, by implementing reduce in a class, I can give the pickling process a callable and some other arguments to run. Potentially, I can execute os.systems and some commands, as also shown by David's POC. Based on its code, I wrote a test exploit which implements the reduce method and execute ls. I gave to the class the same name used by the original pickle, and I generated the serialized string. Looking at the decompiled code, it seems too different from the previous one. However, let's see if the exploit works. Let me copy the string and paste it within the plain B cookie. Crap. Internal server error. Probably the two objects differ too much. After some trial and error, I figured out how to generate almost the same serialized object. The script simply defines a void constructor and then generates the corresponding pickle. The two, however, are still different. Looking in the meaning of the decompiled set item opcode, I found out that it adds a pair of key value to an existing dictionary, meaning that my custom object must be pickled inside a dictionary in order to be equal to the original one. Good. The two objects are now the same. I have successfully reversed the original pickle and I'm able to generate valid serialized objects. Let's try to implement the reduce method within this class and see if it works now that the result is the same as the original. It works. Although it did not show the result of the executed command, the server did not throw an internal server error. Instead, it printed a zero, which is the value returned by the command. As said by this user on Stack Exchange, system just runs the process. It doesn't capture the output. In order to obtain the output of the command, it is necessary to use a different function, like subprocess.checkOutput. Okay, let's implement the new function. Damn, it is better if I reread the documentation. Right, I must return a tuple containing the function to call and a tuple of arguments. Maybe we are done. Oh my gosh! Wait, this should be correct. Maybe Python 3 and Python 2 behave differently when generating the serialized object. The server uses Python 2, so let's try with that version. Here we go! I have successfully executed the ls command. The serialized object sent to the server successfully executes arbitrary code once unserialized thanks to the reduce function. Now let's update the script and obtain the flag. Good job, Morty. Now I have to go to family therapy, he said.